Well, a classical form of Indian dance is coming to the Thomas Crane Public Library this month called Odissi, performed by Mouli Pal. This is going to be on Sunday, February the 8th from 3 to 4 p.m. But you get a preview right now because she's here to tell us a little bit more about herself and the performance. So, Mouli, welcome and thank you for coming over. Appreciate it.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. I'm looking forward to presenting at the library.
Talk to us a little bit about yourself, your background, your education, and how you got into this form of dance and what it is.
I have always been interested in dance, and it's been part of my upbringing. So it has always balanced my journey in trying to pursue my academics, because it would be something that I could that would refresh me, that would invigorate me, and would also enrich my life. Mm-hmm. So eventually, I ended up pursuing this more intensely, and because I enjoy sharing my experience about the dance while I teach, while I perform, and while I reach out. So, although I've been professionally, I'm a financial analyst, but I have decided to dedicate my time mostly to Indian classical dance and to reach out with the beauty of the dance.
What opposite ends of the spectrum that is from finance to dance, or are they connected in some way?
I think it is, because it, like I said, it's the balance between the materialistic, normal human life, and then to find the deeper, inner person through the dance.
What is Odissi?
Odissi is a very ancient dance form that originated in the temples of Orissa. It used to be performed by these very beautiful and educated dancers who lived in the temple and who used to dance as part of the daily worship rituals. So then over time, this system was abolished because these dancers were often not treated well. So to protect them, the system was abolished. But then in order to continue the tradition of the dance form, it evolved as a different system called Gotipua, where young boys were dressed up as girls, young village boys, and they were asked to they were trained to perform the dance. And then in the past 50 years, the dance has really evolved as a formal classical dance form. And several eminent dancers and gurus, they came together to reform the dance and to present it. And my Guruji, the late Guru Kelichan Mahapatra, was one of the major architects of the dance form.
So you trained under the best, basically.
I have been very fortunate, and so he along with his senior disciples have worked, and so today the dance is internationally performed by dancers of all origins in several countries all over the world.
Now, as I understand it from what I've read, at least the dance itself is to portray different forms of architecture or figures.
So the dance is it is multidimensional. It is very deep. It is, firstly, it is not just about movements, and it is not about only entertaining. It is to enrich and enlighten. So, and it portrays different emotions. It portrays storytelling. So there is this aspect of the dance, which we say abhinaya, or expressive dance, where the dancer is using the facial expressions and hand gestures to tell stories or to convey emotions.
I see, okay.
And to enact the songs.
It reminds me of a Hawaiian hula, almost.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
And there is also the pure dance aspect, where the dancer is giving visual representation to the rich music that it is being accompanied to it.
I see.
So it is multidimensional. There are different phases of the dance.
So talk to us a little bit about what you'll be performing here at the library.
I will be presenting a formal Odissi repertoire. So I'll be beginning with Mangalacharan, which is a invocational piece where the dancer comes and invokes the blessing of Lord Jagannath, the Lord of the universe, for an auspicious beginning.
Happy
And then I will present a Pallavi, which is a pure dance piece. So a Pallavi is a very beautiful piece which is like a flowering tree.
Okay.
So the basic music is like the trunk of a tree, and that it develops into branches and leaves and flowers. Mm-hmm. So the music becomes more intricate. So it starts as a slow-paced dance, and then it becomes fast-paced.
Okay.
So I plan to present a Pallavi, which is a pure dance, and then I'll move into the storytelling aspect of the dance, which is an Abhinaya. Think about India today, we think about the glamour of the Bollywood dances, but India is a land of where maths originated, where dance originated, where yoga originated, and it's so much about deep philosophical aspect. Because when a dancer is performing, it is nothing superficial. It's from the depth of the person, the dancer trying to reach her inner spiritual existence and connect with the audience. So it's a journey. It's a journey that involves the audience. So it is not about the movements or the dance as a entertainment here.
I
guess they will get to connect with the with something deep through the dance as a journey.
So each person would experience it differently then, depending on their background and experience.
Yes,
yeah.
And they would come to know more about the ancient heritage of India. I will also talk about the temple sculptures. So it would give a glimpse into the temple architecture, into the poetries and literature, and into the ancient heritage of India.
Sounds
so it would essentially be a glimpse into India.
It sounds fascinating. Fascinating and very different for us here at the Thomas Crane, so we look forward to it. Thank you so much for stopping by and chatting with us about it.
Welcome. Thank you.